A Forest Apart by Troy Denning was released in 2003 as a 50-page ebook novella to supplement his novel Tatooine Ghost. As with most of the ebook releases, it was later included in the paperback edition of Tatooine Ghost that came out in 2004, as well as another short story by Denning, Corfellian Interlude. The more of these ebooks that I read, the more I find that I pretty much miss them the first go around. But I was excited to read this one because I do really like Chewie's family and I was interested in spending a little bit more time with them. So, a brief summary. While Chewie's wife and son visit him on Coruscant, the whole Wookiee family becomes caught up in the theft of a datapad that contains important information for the New Republic. So first, a timeline disclaimer. A Forest Apart is set after The Courtship of Princess Leia, but before Tatooine Ghost. But there's a line in the final chapter that allows us to date it very precisely, more precisely than some of these stories usually let us do. Chewie mentions that it has been a year and a half since the death of Isayn Isard at the end of the Bacta War, so there you go. A Forest Apart is 18 months after The Bacta War by Michael A. Stackpole. So first, the good. Perhaps because of the notoriety of the Star Wars Holiday Special, a lot of books didn't cover Chewie's family much. We saw them in the Black Fleet Crisis Trilogy by Michael P. QB McDowell, and his nephew Lobaka shows up in the Young Jedi Knights books and more books going forward. But really, other than the Han Solo Trilogy, which has Chewbacca reuniting with Malla after 50 years of captivity, we don't spend a lot of time with Chewie's family. Part of that is just the constraints of the life debt that he's under, that he spends most of his time with Han and doesn't get many opportunities to head back to his homeworld to spend time with his Wookiee family. I mean, even in Heir to the Empire, when Chewie and Leia are hiding out among the Wookiees, we don't see Malla and Lumpy at all. So I really enjoyed getting to see them here, getting to see that it's not always Chewie going to them, but sometimes they come to Chewie and visit him on Coruscant. That Malla thinks it's fascinating, she loves to look at the traffic, and that while it may not be a world they would like to live on, it's definitely a world that they are happy to visit. Lumpy's going through those adolescent Wookiee years where he wants to emulate his father. He's trying to stand up for his family's honor, but he doesn't know what he's doing and he gets the short end of the stick in young Wookiee fights. And Maul is essentially having to serve as a single parent that because of the life debt, Chewie's not there a lot, so she's having to raise Lumpy mostly on her own. And after the initial confusion, which I'll get into a bit later in the meh section, of this being like a mystery adventure story told from Chewie's point of view, I was interested in seeing how they would tackle this. Lumpy takes the initiative to chase after the thief, his parents follow, then Lumpy is abducted by these nefarious underworld goers. His parents chase after, and then they're reunited, and they have to figure out how to stop the villain at the end. I liked how ingenious Lumpy was, despite his lack of physical fighting skills. And I really love the scene where they take over the speeder and Mala's using a datapad to communicate with the Rodian driver, and it's basically just Mama Bear. She threatens to rip his antenna off while she has a perfectly straight face all the time. It did make me laugh. But on the more meh side, I found that reading the ebook itself, just A Forest Apart, had some weird formatting things, which is basically that all of the Wookiee speech was presented as just normal speech. And it was a little jarring because Chewie would say something and then people would just look at him because they don't understand the Wookiee language. And I wondered, could there have been a way to format his speech better so that it was apparent, you know, he's speaking in Shriwook, and these people don't understand it? And the answer is yes. If you look at Tatooine Ghost, which both the paperback version and the ebook version contain Corfellian Interlude and A Forest Apart, they represent the Wookiee speech with brackets, which makes it much more obvious that they are speaking a different language than the people around them. And so I just wonder, what happened here with the ebook? Like, was brackets the original formatting, or did they originally just have normal dialogue and people were confused, and so they added the brackets when they put it in Tatooine Ghost? Because that was just one change that made it easier to read, and is why I would suggest, if you're interested in reading the story, that you just seek out Tatooine Ghost, because the way it's formatted in Tatooine Ghost works better than the actual ebook. While I enjoyed seeing Malla play the mama bear, I wish that we could have had a little bit more of her, because since it's in Chewie's viewpoint, we get a lot of Chewie, we get some of Lumpy, but I felt like Malla suffered a little as a result. Mala's just there to be like, Chewie, that's dangerous, or for Chewie to say, Malla, don't do that, and Malla's a very resourceful individual, and I wish I could have seen more of that, more of how she's Chewie's equal. Well, I'm sure that Wookiee society has different roles for different individuals, and perhaps these are gender roles as well. I think just the fact that Malla has been essentially raising her son on her own would make her more resourceful than the story depicts her as being. And finally, A Forest Apart is only 4 chapters long. It's 50 pages, it's short. What that means is that they stop the bad guy, who is an Imperial interrogator droid who is using these underworld denizens to help him steal a data pad so that then they can cause mischief during a Provisional Council event. The Wookiees are chasing after the thief. Then they find out that the big brains behind the situation is this Imperial interrogator droid, and they realize they have to destroy the droid and destroy the data pad. And they do that, and then it just ends. And they're still down there, all the way in the deep underbelly of Coruscant, and they're like, we need to let New Republic intelligence know. But that's where it ends. And I think I would have liked a little bit more resolution, them coming back up, letting them know what happened, or at least seeing how they got back to their apartment after this grand adventure through the depths of Coruscant. As it was, it just sort of ended, and I was like, okay, that's it? That's it? And as a bit of false advertising, Han's picture is on the cover of the ebook. It's Chewie and Han. Han does not appear in here at all, and while I can see that it's one of those Photoshop CGI covers, like, I would have loved to see Lumpy and Malla on here, the whole Wookiee family, instead of a character who is only talked about and never actually appears. So, in short, A Forest Apart is a fun adventure with Chewie and Malla and Lumpy. Is it worth seeking out the ebook on its own? No, don't do that. Not just because I think a 50-page ebook is not worth it, but also because of some formatting issues. But if you're able to get your hands on the paperback of Tatooine Ghost or the ebook of Tatooine Ghost, it's included in there, and I would definitely read it because it was fun. I love getting to see Chewie spend time with his family and his family being equal to the adventures that Chewie himself undertakes. And like I said, it's 4 chapters, it's 50 pages, so it doesn't take very long to read. So next time, I'm going to be reading a Han and Leia story set prior to the Thrawn trilogy, Tatooine Ghost by Troy Denning. I just filmed my review, and it would have been perfect for Sammy to join me because it's about Wookiees. But no, Sammy is mad that she can't go out on the porch.